Man United are in a horrible place right now. We're 2 points above the relegation zone. 2 points. And after 6 years of almost inconceivable negligence and mismanagement from the very, very top at Manchester United, the club is in absolute disarray. A lot of United fans have lost faith in Solskjaer. A lot of other United fans are pointing their fingers towards Glazers and the board. But it's not a good situation or time for anybody at United. And there is a lot to be asked, a lot of questions to be asked, and I've got a lot I'd like to say as well about the whole situation. But for today, I want to focus on what Gary Neville had to say after the game against Newcastle, the 1-0 defeat, as I always like to. And I want to hear what he has to say and give my own opinion on whether his points are fair or wrong. Now, before we do get into this video, make sure you subscribe if you are new. But let's talk about United. Now, quickly before we do begin, I just want to remind you that we have partnered with The Athletic, who are changing the face of UK journalism. There is a lot of post-Newcastle reaction on there. There's going to be some great articles going up this week as well. A world-class team of writers, including David Ornstein, who has moved from the BBC over to The Athletic to join the likes of Andy Mitten and Laurie Whitwell and a host of other writers. It's completely ad-free. There's no pop-ups. It's just great football content. Now, with the link in the description from United People's TV, you get a 30-day free trial and 50% off an annual subscription. I really do encourage you to go over there and subscribe because there's a lot of great content. But let's talk about what Gary had to say after the 1-0 defeat to Newcastle. For me, the first thing here was Gary pointing the finger towards the board and not holding back.
And the board are going to need to hold their nerve.
But why do they need to hold their nerve, Gary? Could there be a theory here, just a theory, that he might not be the right man?
Because they've cocked this up over many years.
But what if Ollie is not the right man to put them back on track?
They've cocked it up. They're responsible for this. Poor recruitment. Poor selection of... Well, managers and then going with them and then pulling off them. Van Gaal won an FA Cup, then they sacked him. Jose Mourinho, they sacked him after 2.5 years when they'd given him a contract 6 months before. So they've pulled off managers in terms of what would be the sort of thread of it, and they've gone for completely different styles of managers in Louis van Gaal and Jose Mourinho. They've now gone with Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, who's taken the club in a completely different direction again. If you change direction as a board every 2 years and you invest 250 million quid along the way in each manager, you're going to have big problems. And Manchester United are basically now getting the pain that they deserve for poor decisions at board level. And Ole Gunnar Solskjaer needs to make sure that the clean-up job that he's doing, which he needs to be done at this football club for the mess that's gone before him, he needs to make sure that he's somebody that actually gets the opportunity to spend that 250, 300 million that the others have had to spend so that he can have an opportunity.
It is about time, I think, that Gary really points the finger towards the Glazers, towards the United board, which for me have created the circumstances which we now find ourselves in. They've gone for David Moyes after Fergie recommended him without any sort of interview process. He failed. They went for Louis van Gaal. I say they. Ed Woodward went for Louis van Gaal, the experienced man. He was backed. He failed. Jose Mourinho came in, the serial winner. He was backed to a point. He failed. Then we turn to the club legend in Solskjaer, and he's currently failing. The common denominator about all four of these managers? Ed Woodward, the structure of the board, and United. It's not fucking new to hear United fans moaning about the problems of the mismanagement behind the scenes. But that's because it's the actual cause of the problem. We're banging a drum here. Maybe that will never change a thing. But you can't just ignore what the main problem is. And what I want to do here quickly is highlight just a few facts and stats that prove just how bad the board has done in the last 6 years. In 2017, United's revenue was £217 million more than Liverpool. In 2019-20, that could be reduced to zero, depending on the success of the season for Liverpool and United. Since Sir Alex Ferguson retired in 2013, United's wage bill has increased 83%. As of 2019, United have paid over £800 million out of the club in interest repayments on the Glazers' loan. That's more than the loan itself. We're now paying dividends to the Glazers, And as of 2019, United owe £188 million to transfer creditors. In 2013, that was only £34 million. The facts and the figures do not lie. United's on-the-pitch failures are now massively directly affecting the price of the club, the investment that the Glazers have. And that's the only reason Ed Woodward's ever kept his job until now, because 6 years of just catastrophic failures and poor decisions haven't lost him his job, because the numbers have been all right. The numbers are not right anymore. So if this isn't the catalyst for the right sort of change at United, then nothing ever fucking will be, because we're such a poorly mismanaged club that we can't ever expect success. The circumstances for sustained success at United do not exist. You can get a Europa League here, an FA Cup there, a League Cup there, but you need consistency to win the league. You need consistency to win the Champions League. And we don't have the circumstances that allow that at the moment, and it's not because of Solskjaer. It's because of how the club is run. Now, I'm not saying that Solskjaer is guilt-free in this, because he's absolutely not. There's clear problems with him. For me, it looks like he's over his head now. Tactically, he's not right. He's not changing the problems. But the problems run so much deeper than Solskjaer that he should still never be the person that you point your finger towards, not at United, because that's not the change that's going to change us, because we'll have the same conversation in 18 months or 2 years' time with another manager. And I'm bored of that. We've done it with Moyes, Van Gaal, Mourinho, and now we're doing it with Solskjaer. We'll do the exact same with the next manager unless something actually truly changes. And surely you all realise that. But I just don't know what's next for United, because I don't feel that sacking Solskjaer and repeating the same mistakes that we've done previously and going in a new direction is going to help us. But at the same time, sticking with Solskjaer, if it really is going to take us that much further down, how is that going to help us? United have forced themselves into an ugly crossroads, which I don't know where the best path is anymore. And that's all down to the mismanagement from the top level. And of course, that crept over into the summer as well, where Solskjaer wasn't completely backed in the transfer window, and Gary feels that's definitely contributed to the problems that we're seeing at the moment.
Can we think back to investment in this summer? Manchester United spent, I think, 100 and I think it was 40 or 50 million.
150 million.
But they got 75 million for Lukaku. So net spend for the club is 75 million. They got Smalling, Herrera, Fellaini, and Sanchez off the wage bill, part of his wage off the, and Lukaku's wage off the transfer, off the wage bill. That's probably 25, 30 million a year. They probably saved another 25, 30 million on top of the 70. They probably invested about 40 million quid this year, Manchester United's board, in the squad. I think part of that was because they didn't want to make too many mistakes like they had done previously, and they couldn't get the players they wanted. But that isn't going to be enough to correct what's gone on before. They need a net spend of probably 152.
So is that the new direction you're talking about?
No. Graham, the club has recruited so badly. Every time you recruit badly, you pay for it.
But what is
the club has paid for it.
It's not as if United have underinvested. We've spent nearly a billion on new signings since Fergie retired, but we haven't spent it smartly. And we didn't back Solskjaer completely this summer. You can't tell me that Solskjaer went into this summer not expecting to sign a central midfielder. And after Lukaku made it clear he didn't want to be here, I think he would have wanted a new striker as well. What Solskjaer is doing in saying he's happy with his squad is that he's coping with what he's been given. We've got the new centre-back in Maguire and the right-back in Wan-Bissaka and, an unknown quantity in Dan James, but we needed a central midfielder. Have we signed a powerful central midfielder, someone like Ndombele and someone like Bruno Fernandes, to bolster what was the weakest point in the entire squad? These problems would not be surfacing like they are this season. The fact that we're having injuries, it's making it worse. But we had 6 academy players, I think, on the pitch against Newcastle. And I am all for the academy players getting brought through. But right now, they are getting used. Just like I think Scott McTominay got used a little bit by Jose Mourinho towards the end as a pawn for him to use against the club. I feel that's the situation that we're being stuck in now, because it doesn't look like Gomez is ready for the first team. I know Chong's definitely not ready for the first team. Brandon Williams, is he ready? Maybe he's more ready than we all think, but maybe not. Mason Greenwood, for a player who's considered to be ready, still isn't starting up front, and Solskjaer's still backing Rashford. There are so many players that have the talent, but haven't got the players around them to allow their talents to grow, as Gary Neville said, organically. It's not organic growth. It's, fuck it. We haven't got any players. In you go. Oh, you're not doing that good. Nothing you can do. You've got to play every single damn week. Rashford is getting ruined in this current United setup. He shouldn't be playing every single minute of every single game. And I'm still not sure that number nine is his best position. Maybe left wing is his best position. But he's getting ruined because he's our main man. And I refuse to believe that Solskjaer sold Lukaku and Sanchez willingly and in his mind felt that he had enough going into this season. That might have been the circumstances he was given, but I don't think he wanted that. And I think the Glazers have underinvested this summer and it's caused the problems to be 10 times worse than they are. Scott McTominay should never be the best midfielder in a United setup, but he is right now. And it's a measure of how bad and threadbare this squad is. Now, Solskjaer is partly responsible because the likes of Herrera, Fellaini, Sanchez, Lukaku, Darmian, they all left and not enough replacements came in. But that, for me, isn't down to Solskjaer, if I'm honest. It's down to the powers that be above him. And that's why all fingers and every single problem at the club, when you look at the root of it, it goes back to the board. It goes back to the Glazers. But it leaves United at a massive, massive crossroads. Do United now stick with Solskjaer, try and get through to January, improve our results, try and spend in January, bring in the signings we should have done in the summer, and hope that we will continue to improve? Or do we sack Solskjaer? Do we go in a new direction? Do we bring in a new manager and effectively start that rebuild all over again? I don't know what we're going to do. Look, I don't think Solskjaer is the manager that's going to win us the league again. But I fear for what it means if United just get rid of him. Just go, that didn't work. What's next? And we repeat the same damn mistakes with the people who are responsible for the problems getting away with it again. Nothing will change, people. In 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 years' time, we'll still be having this same conversation. And that is a massive fear of mine. It's at a crossroads which we've now been forced into as fans because it does look like Solskjaer's in over his head. But what's next? Does Solskjaer maybe go into a director of football position? We go and get a different manager in and try and get Solskjaer to work in that role instead, which I think he's got credentials for, but he won't be happy with that. He won't leave the job as a manager, go into a lesser position and let someone else take centre stage. Solskjaer's got an ego. Every human has an ego when they're working in a position of power like that. It's just that the person with the biggest ego is the person with the most power at United. And Ed Woodward, I'm really fucking bored of pointing the finger at him. Everybody knows he's the problem with the Glazers. But maybe the fact that the on-the-pitch performances are finally affecting the price of the club, their investment, that maybe they'll see the negligence for what it is and that change will happen. I don't know. But United right now, as I said, we're at a horrible crossroads where a lot of fans are losing faith in Solskjaer as the manager. But when you try and figure out the route upwards, it's almost impossible with the current conditions at United. And I don't know how that's going to change. But what do you think about what Gary had to say? The fair points I think he raised about the board being responsible for the majority of it, talking about the underinvestment. Let me know what you think. Where do you stand on Solskjaer at the moment? Let me know in the comments below. Unfortunately for Ole, it's going to be a long couple of weeks. And then we've got Liverpool. And if we lose to Liverpool, which we probably will, United could be in the relegation zone. Think about that.